Here at Vans Aircraft, we've rigorously tested the RV-14 and RV-14A in accordance with FAR Part 23 design requirements. What kind of testing are we talking about?
Drop testing. Again. And again. And again.
During the design process, we separate the design of the aircraft structure into many smaller pieces, creating a 3D model from which we can calculate loads, stresses, flexing, and other structural behavior. This process is called finite element analysis, or FEA. FEA allows us to refine the structure of the aircraft in the computer before ever performing a real-world test, so we can design a very strong airframe while avoiding excess weight. Even though the RV-14 is an experimental, amateur-built aircraft and not subject to certification requirements, Vans tests the majority of the design to FAR Part 23, the same tests used by certified aircraft manufacturers. Here's an example drop test setup. This test will be for limit load, level landing, and forward center of gravity, or CG. Limit load refers to the maximum load that a structure can safely carry in a real-world application. During this test, we need to simulate the aircraft traveling at or below stall speed, as well as having a high descent rate. To duplicate this effect, we modify the angle of the drop test article to use gravity to simulate both the forward motion of the aircraft and the descent rate. Under ideal conditions, even at a full stall, the RV-14 airfoil still provides approximately two-thirds of its normal lift, effectively cushioning the descent rate in a real-world, full-stall drop-in landing. Unfortunately, we don't have an anti-gravity device at Vans configured to simulate this, so we alter the drop test weight. The drop height shown in the tests, combined with the calculated weight and angles, is equivalent to a drop from a higher altitude. Keep in mind the mass of the aircraft, multiplied by the acceleration of gravity, multiplied by the drop height, equates to a specific energy that we want to put into the aircraft. We can change the drop height or mass of the fuselage to achieve that energy. Too little energy and we haven't tested effectively. Too much and, well, you get the idea. To simulate the worst case scenarios for each component of the landing gear system, we vary the angle of the drop tests and CG location for the main gear, nose gear, and tail spring. Measuring the deflection of a gear leg when a load is applied allows us to model the gear leg as a spring. By measuring how much this spring deflects and using an accelerometer to determine the rate at which that happens, we can measure the energy transferred into the landing gear. This verifies that the drop test article has been dropped from the proper height with the proper weight. This is drop test 28, a worst case test for a level or wheel landing in the tail dragger configuration. We also tested for a series of tail down or three-point landings in various CG configurations. Here you can see the patented Vans deflectometer in action, measuring the stroke of the landing gear. You can also see why the tailwheel spring has been curved, to allow greater deflection without contacting the bottom of the rudder. Remember that the limit load is the maximum load the aircraft is expected to safely carry. Multiplied by a factor of 1.5, we wind up with a value called the ultimate load. In an ultimate test, the structure is allowed to permanently deform but may not fail catastrophically. This is drop test 42. Technically, we could use an entirely new airframe for each successive drop test, but the article you see in each of these videos is the same airframe, with zero component replacement. Notice that the airframe passes this test with zero deformation, meaning that after a landing 1.5 times as severe as a limit landing, the airframe has still not deformed. The RV-14A nose wheel is similar in design principle to the RV-10, which has proven to be very effective and trouble-free. Fork, leg, link assembly, elastomers, and engine mount have all undergone strenuous FEA computer modeling, and the end result is, well, see for yourself. The platforms and the drop angle help incorporate that all-important forward velocity vector while maintaining simultaneous touchdown of all three wheels. Here's the worst-case scenario for the nose wheel at forward CG. Tail-down configurations help us validate the new main gear leaf spring design. This was the ultimate test for the main gear. Remember, an ultimate test is 1.5 times greater than the maximum load the aircraft is ever expected to carry. If you landed this hard, the wheels wouldn't quite touch the bottom of the wings, thanks to wing dihedral, but you might owe yourself some new wheel pants, and probably some new underpants as well. We also tortured the landing gear in other ways. Pulling the landing gear aft simulates a braking roll condition. And since not all landings are straight down the runway, we also simulate side loads. Here the whole team gathers for the final aft CG drop of the RV-14A. Passed with flying colors, well, dropping colors anyway. So the next time you're dreaming about flying your RV-14, remember the vast assortment of abuse, stress, and torture this airframe has undergone. We're confident you'll have as much fun building and flying your airplane as we've had designing it. Welcome to the next generation of Vans Aircraft Total Performance.